What is up, everyone? It is Nick here, and what are we doing today? We are playing Kingdom Hearts. This is actually my first LP series ever, where it's just kind of like by myself, actually playing like a normal game. So we'll see how this goes. I plan episodes to be like 20 minutes-ish. Light editing, there's not going to be any like hardcore stuff. This is going to pretty much just be a straight LP. And maybe once I do ever a couple episodes, I'm thinking I'm making a highlight reel. I really like watching highlight reels, so I'm sure you guys would too. So that's my plan with that, and let's just get started. No point wasting time. Let's normal difficulty, because I don't want to make this harder than it has to be and I get stuck somewhere. I'm going to aim for episodes to be about 20 minutes, and I'm using an emulator. I'm using GSDX. Actually, I have the disc in my PC. I'm playing it off of that. And I'm just going to shut up during this first cutscene because I like the song that plays.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
Okay, and I'm back. So that was the intro. I really like that song. I actually listen to it a lot. It's on my music player, and it's on all my playlists. It's one of my favorite songs ever. I actually have the Japanese version, too. There's parts of both songs I like. But this is the beginning of Kingdom Hearts. I plan these videos to be around 20 minutes, but I'm not going to stop it in like a middle of a boss battle. So if there's like a boss battle or something interesting happening, obviously I'm not going to cut it there, and if it's a 40-minute video, it would be 40 minutes, but around 20 minutes, I actually have a timer up, so I can time it, so I can get videos to be 20 minutes, because I like saying goodbye at the end of the episodes and hello at the beginning of the next episode. I just feel it's a bit better than just like cutting it off in the middle of me playing. So that's what my idea is. Anyway, here we have two. Wait, what? Is that how the camera works? I haven't played this game in so long. So I've been reading like the guides and stuff. Just for stats, I'm gonna choose this. It just to get the highest stats in the game, you're gonna have to take the wand. Each one gives you different stats. The sword doesn't really give you any good stats. Also, with the wand, it gives you more ability slots and whatnot. I think on the second thing you get rid of, you just low. I'll just lose 2 points in defense. I think the other one you just gain 2 points in, and it also is your skill tree that you branch on. And just the skill tree for the wand is a bit better than the others. It's a bit easier. Actually, I think the shield is technically the easiest one. And after that, once we get out of this tutorial area, there'll be another choice where we have to answer 3 questions and that'll determine how fast we level up. So you can depart at dawn, noon, or dusk. We're going to try to depart at dusk. I'll tell you why later. Let's get through the tutorial first and whatnot. Nice music. I like it. Have to try to find the right balance of audio and whatnot. Oh, also, I guess I should talk about this. This is the first episode. I am using an emulator. I'm not pirating the game or anything. I actually have it in my PC DVD drive. I actually like how you can do that. It's pretty neat. I would be using my PS3 controller, but I just moved to this house and it's in a box somewhere, so I'm using my 360 controller for this first episode, probably. Hopefully I'll get that resolved, because I would rather play with my PS3 controller. I actually found one of them, but it's the broken one, which is too bad. Yeah, so I'm using PCXX. I'm playing at 4x resolution with playing at 720p. The internal resolution is 4x whatever the native is. I think I got it to 16:9. I don't think it's 4:3 stretch. Oh god, I'll have to remember how to play this game. Especially with my microphone. My A key is sticking in my Xbox controller. Need to get my PS3 one out. You gain experience for just tutorial stuff. I don't really need to read. It's all pretty self-explanatory. I forgot that the camera's not controlled by the right stick. I might change that if I don't like this. Because I can bind things differently. That's the nice thing about emulators. I also have anti-aliasing up all the way to like 8x, which is really nice. Yep. Targeting. Whatnot. That's fun. I really like the battle system in this game. Oh, come on. I can't hit anything. Okay. Let's stop just like flailing about randomly. That's not going to get us anywhere. I was reading some other stuff on it just before I started so I can remember what the hell I was doing. You get like one experience point for killing things, but actually, if you like counterattack them, you get 2. That's what the one piece is, apparently. So I was reading about that. That's real neat and whatnot. What's happening now? Is this the boss? Don't remember. Oh no, we're getting sucked down! Whoa! I haven't played this game in probably... God, has it been like a decade? No, the game wasn't out then. This game holds up really well. Like, some of the black lines are like really crisp, and then some of the textures aren't so good. You can tell which one are vector textures versus like textures in the game. Oh, that's what the right stick does. It changes that. Well, I might change that. Okay, I guess we're going through the door. Don't remember this. Actually, I kind of do. Let's see. Examine. Yeah, this game holds up a lot better than I thought it would. I wonder what it looks like if you take like anti-aliasing off and scale back down to 1x resolution. It's not 720p. Who needs HD versions when you can just do this? Okay, Drew's messaging me. He says, come over. Just ignore that, I guess. What did I get? A potion? I wasn't reading it. You can push large crates. This is the platforming aspect of the game, occasionally. Waha. Yeah, there's some platforming in it. I don't think there's much, if I remember. But who knows? I could have completely forgotten everything. What does it want me to do? Can I break it? Watcha! Sometimes destroying objects yields items. Yeah, we got a potion. And now the tutorial door is going to let us through. You can lock onto objects too. So lock onto the object and press L2. Okay. Oh, that's how you change. Do you even lift, bro? Wahahaha. Oh, okay. Just going to let that go. It's cool. That's cool. Let's go through the door now. Oh, okay. Gotta remember the controls. Those door handles are very high quality. What? Through the doors that light and we're in the darkness now? Yeah. It's one of the things this game is about. I don't really remember what it's about too much. It's like light and dark. And there's Mickey Mouse and stuff. Yeah, I don't really remember much. And maybe I was just too young to get the story. Aha. I think this is where we answer the three questions. And now we're on Destiny Island. Press select on your first person view, which is completely useless, and I've never used it ever because it's completely useless, but woo, we can do that. Anyway, select talk. So it's the first one now. They're changing it up on me. What's most important to you? Okay, so they're going to ask me three questions, and it's going to depend. It's going to, what the questions do is you get three times you depart at. You depart at dusk. It's dusk, probably like noon and dawn. That's the other one, stupid me. The other D one. And the three correspond to the three. So I think if you choose the third option every time for all of these guys, we'll get to leave at dusk. And if we leave at dusk, it'll be harder to level up for the first 40 levels, but after that, it'll get easier. If you depart at noon, it's, it stays the same difficulty throughout, and if you choose to depart at dawn, you level up quicker for the first 40 levels. Overall, if you choose to depart at dusk... Oh, no, 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 no! Oh, no, I chose the wrong one. I might have to redo that. Stupid Xbox controller bouncing back on me. If you choose dusk versus, like, dawn, it's, like, 10% less experience that you have to get overall. If you want to get to level 100, I don't know if I'm going to do that. Maybe not. Probably beat the game long before that on second thought. Oh, I didn't even read what it said. I really didn't... God damn it, I have to do this again. Being indecisive, whatever. Just answer the questions so I can get my leave at dusk. Dawn. Whatever one's nighttime. Oh, God. No, dusk? Yeah, we only have a dusk. Dawn's in the morning. I had to think about that. I'm so silly. Okay. You're afraid of being... Yeah, whatever, whatever. You like to collect neat things. When does my journey begin? Your adventure begins in the dead of night. There we go. That's what we need. Sounds good. So for the first 40 levels, it'll be a bit harder. Actually, you need like 33,000 XP to get to level 40 if you depart either way, but you'll get to like level 30 faster if you choose to leave in the morning versus night. I like saying morning and night better, even though all the guides call them dusk and dawn. Less confusing. Maybe I'm just dumb. That's probably it, actually. Okay, what are we doing on this platform? My blinds? Maybe. Press the start button to open this menu. Why? Okay. Whatever that princess is, I don't even know what it is. And there's more heartless. Oh my god, let's go fight it. Rawr. Okay. Wahaha. Oh god, they're everywhere. What are we gonna do? These guys are annoying just because they go on the ground, but they're pretty easy to kill. Basic enemy type. Like, just like hack and slash at them. I don't remember any of the other controls. Game, teach me. I need you to tutorial me hard. The locking on feature's nice. It helps that stupid camera that's bound to the freaking L buttons. I'm just jumping instead of hitting the attack button. Don't worry, I'll get used to the controls sooner than later, hopefully. Oh, come on. Watcha. Watcha. I wish I had the sword. The sword looks cooler, but... The stats were, from what I read, the stats aren't good. And it's actually harder if you choose the sword. I didn't read why, just like, whatever. Seems legit. Yeah, I just read the guide because I forgot what the different options do. I don't want to, as a kid, I just kind of chose whatever. look shiny, probably. But nah, I like stats and whatnot. Looks like the first episode's gonna end when we get out of this place and onto Destiny Island. This is the save point. Yep. It's a save point, guys. Real hardcore stuff there. Is that Snow White? No, dummy, that's not Snow White. Am I stupid? That's the girl from Beauty and the Beast, if I'm not mistaken. I have no idea what her name is. yeah, that's my thing about this game. It has all the younger kid characters. Maybe that's why I like it so much. I don't really know. I don't know any of them anymore. So that's a thing. Here's the boss battle, isn't it?
Wow.
Looking up at the stars. The closer you get to the light, the greater your shadow becomes. Yeah, it has this light and dark thing. I should read about what it means more. Oh, it's Dark Sora. That's cute. Sora's feet are so big. It's pretty funny. Oh, okay, Dark Sora just became a giant freaking boss. And by boss, it's actually, even if you lose to him, you still complete the tutorial. It doesn't really matter. Wahaha, I am the boss. I shall kill you. I am also... What's that person called? Like, is it Cthulhu now? Maybe. I don't know. Whatever. Wah. Yeah, very basic moveset. You just pretty much, he like attacks the ground and then you go over and hit his hand and he spawns Heartless, which is kind of annoying. But there's something to mess around with. It's the tutorial area, so it should be easy. You like just jump up and like wail on your hand. Wow, why? It's weird. He keeps on like walking. I don't like that. Whatever.
Watcha!
Experience is mine. I wonder if you lose all the experience points afterwards, or if it's even like worth going after. Probably spawning more Heartless, ain't he? Oh no, they're just like heat-seeking missiles. I don't even remember that. Waha, just wailing his hand. I wonder if this is actually doing any damage to him. Oh, I just got hit a little. That's gotta hurt. Oh, come on. You can jump, jump,
jump, I believe in you.
You need to learn how to do combos and stuff again. Oh, there we go, there's your hand. Let me just nom on that a little bit. Let's go back over here. The camera, oof. This is a very interesting layout, I guess. That's one way to phrase it. Yeah, I don't know if I like how the camera works. Maybe I'll get used to it. But when you lock on, it's actually much better.
Waha!
Kill all the Heartless. I wonder if this is like a timed battle, if he does really have health and I'm slowly wailing him down. Is that the only thing? Wait, L2? Yeah, those are the only two targets I can hit on him. Can I actually jump up high enough? Nope. Sora, come on. I believe in you. Jump. Yeah, if we like just jump and swing in his hand. Oh, okay, that did hit us. And did we beat him? Oh, we did beat him. Nice, and we leveled up. Haha, who said departing at night would be harder to level up? It's easy mode. Although it's only level 2. Maybe it's level 1. And we're level 0. Who knows? Could figure that out pretty easy if I hit start whenever we're not in a battle or cutscene like this. But don't be afraid. Oh, we're getting consumed by the darkness. That's very, very tasty. You hold the mightiest weapon of the home. Oh, God, I can't even talk. Oh my God, it's the Keyblade. Spoiler alert. So don't forget. His eyes are very blue. You know how old Sora is and he's just on an island by himself? You are the one who will open the door. Bum, bum, bum. I've only played Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2. I haven't actually played any other ones. But actually, right here is a great time to end the episode. It's been 19 minutes. So that was this episode, and I'll see you in the next part. Goodbye, guys.